Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today's video I'm going to be talking about how to get a medical waiver in order to join the military if you might have a or think you might have a disqualifying factor. When going to MEPS, each military branch does have their own set of medical standards. However, I'm going to be just talking about the Air Force because I am currently enlisted in the United States Air Force. When going to MEPS, you do have to fill out a medical form and then you will also have a medical examination. Now, let's talk about the two different types of disqualifications. There is going to be temporary disqualification and then there is permanent disqualification. Permanent doesn't necessarily mean that you cannot join the military, and temporary does not necessarily mean that you need a waiver. Temporary means that you currently have a disqualifying medical condition, but that will change with time. However, permanent means you have a disqualifying medical condition that is not going to change with time. Therefore, you cannot enlist with a permanent medical condition unless you do get an approved waiver. If you do have a permanent disqualifying factor, the medical doctor at MEPS will state whether or not a waiver is recommended in your case. This is going to be the first step in getting or receiving your medical waiver. Once the doctor at MEPS makes a recommendation, MEPS is completely done with the medical waiver process and then they will pass it on to the recruiting commander. Upon receiving the doctor's recommendation, then the recruiting commander will decide whether or not to request a medical waiver. After that, it does go through a couple more individuals. However, in the end, it will hopefully make its way up to a high-ranking doctor, which is like an 06 or above, who then makes the ultimate decision on whether or not you're going to be receiving your medical waiver. If your medical waiver is denied, then that is the end of your journey, at least for that specific branch. There is no telling whether or not you might get approval in a different branch. There are no appeals because the appeal is going through that process with the medical waiver. Now that I've talked about how you are going to get a medical waiver, I just want to talk about my story because I myself have had to get a medical waiver for a permanent disqualification. As most of you know, I was a D1 athlete at the University of Alaska Anchorage, where I competed in gymnastics. My sophomore year of college, when I was in practice, I did sublux my shoulder. I therefore went and had an MRI and it concluded that I did tear my labrum, which resulted in having arthroscopic shoulder surgery. Now, that surgery alone technically is disqualifying for the military, at least for the Air Force. However, when I was talking to the medical doctor at MEPS, I did tell him that I was able to heal up and compete at the D1 level again after I have already had the surgery. I know when he was filling out my recommendation for a waiver, he did mention that in there, which I believe did help me because at that point I felt like if I could start competing at a D1 collegiate level in gymnastics again, then I could pass the physical standards for the Air Force. The doctor's recommendation did have to go through all those steps, and eventually it did make it to the end and I did get approved because here I am in the military and in the Air Force. Not only that, I am also security forces, which is more hands-on than other jobs, and when joining the military I did not have a single issue with my arm because it was 100%. Now, most of you might know I am on my second surgery for this shoulder. However, I did injure it. It didn't just come with time. I did re-injure it snowboarding. My first surgery did not have anything to do necessarily with my second surgery. I just was a little bit clumsy and got my arm stuck in the snow and my board kept going and yada, yada, yada. So that is why I am currently on my second surgery. However, I do have some exciting news. I just recalled on my firearms, which I qualified on the M18, which is brand new to security forces. We have not used it, but however, I just fired it, so now I'm carrying around an M18, and I did qualify on my M4. Therefore, I am fully equipped to do my job again, which is awesome because it's been a long 7 months. And yeah, I just wanted to point out that good news for you guys. I'm just literally tired of sitting behind a desk. That's one reason why I want to do law enforcement specifically, because we are more hands-on and we get to go out and about and mingle and, you know, do more hands-on stuff. However, being stuck behind a desk is a little bit draining. Now that I have that, I can rotate through my post even more. So I'm super excited for that. Thank you for joining me today. If you guys have any questions or if you guys personally have any experiences with MEPS, go ahead and leave a comment in the section below because everyone is different. That is just how I got my medical waiver. However, it might be different for you. Like I said before, if you're not already subscribed to my channel, then subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit that like button. I hope this was informational for you guys. Hope you guys enjoy your day. Bye.